Fridays are awesome. So are jobs, chocolate, and football. They're all featured today on CNN Student News. First up, the U.S. will be getting a new Attorney General. Eric Holder announced yesterday he'll resign from his job. The Attorney General leads the U.S. Department of Justice. It's the highest legal job in the land. Holder became the first African-American Attorney General in 2009. Opinions of his work are strongly partisan. Democrats generally think he did a good job, saying he made achievements in civil rights. Republicans mostly wanted him out, saying he disregarded the U.S. Constitution. Holder strongly supported same-sex marriage, and he prioritized issues related to voting rights. He also became the first U.S. cabinet member to be held in contempt of Congress after he refused to turn over documents related to a failed government program involving guns and Mexican drug cartels. The latest targets in the U.S.-led war against the ISIS terrorist group, oil refineries in Syria. ISIS has been using these to pay for its operations, getting up to $2 million a day from them. The U.S. wants that stopped, even though a U.S. military official says the group has $1 billion in the bank. ISIS stands for Islamic State in Iraq and Syria. The terrorist group wants its own country in the region based on its own interpretation of Islam. ISIS has slaughtered civilians, soldiers, journalists, and an American defense official says the fight against ISIS will likely last for years. It won't be cheap.
Expanding military strikes into Syria come with an expanded bill to pay for the effort. U.S. military forces and its coalition partners launched air attacks in the country with a blunt force of 47 Tomahawk missiles across northern and eastern Syria. Those weapons, which carry 1,000-pound warheads and can be reprogrammed in flight, have a hefty price tag, $1.5 million apiece. And that's just the beginning. For the first assault, the Pentagon said 4 dozen fighter jets took off from both land and sea, loaded with 200 pieces of munition. Now, between fuel and maintenance, the cost for flying these jets on an hourly basis ranges from $22,000 to $62,000, with the Air Force's newest and most stealthy aircraft, the F-22 Raptor, topping the list. As for the bombs these jets are carrying, outside military experts point to the JDAM, the Joint Direct Attack Munition, which can be launched miles away from the target. Its manufacturer, Boeing, calls it the warfighter's weapon of choice. It goes for about $29,000. And the SDB, the small diameter bomb, which is dubbed the all-weather solution. It goes for about $21,000. Now, it's easy to see how the bill for these operations adds up. The last time we heard from the Pentagon, it said the costs were averaging about $7.5 million a day. But the back of the envelope estimate for the Tomahawks alone is $70 million. Granted, these are missiles the U.S. and its partners have in their arsenals, but those will likely need to be replenished. Bottom line, the average daily cost has to be significantly higher today than it was just a few weeks ago.
From Thursday's transcript page at CNNStudentNews.com, here are three of the thousands who wanted to mention on our roll call. Prowling around Hollis, Oklahoma, say hello to the Tigers. They're at Hollis High School. In Flowood, Mississippi, we've got the Chargers watching. They're at Northwest Rankin Middle School. And over to Germany now. It's great to see everyone at Teresa von Bayern Schule in Munich. A recent report looked at 464 different types of jobs in the U.S. It found that if you're looking to work in a secure profession, one of your best bets is in the medical field. Optometrists, podiatrists, nurses. We're going to need more of them in the years ahead. Also, blue-collar fields, wastewater treatment plant workers, building inspectors. We'll need those too. And if you're going into a STEM field in general, the harder the degree, the better the pay.
STEM. It stands for science, technology, engineering, and math. There is a school of thought there are more jobs than there are qualified people to fill them. The theory? Train more Americans, reduce unemployment, and help the economy. Let's look at the class of 2012. Just 16% of undergraduates got a degree in the STEM majors. That seems small, right? The Obama administration certainly thinks so and has invested millions to increase those numbers. But is it worth it? Some say no. They say there is no skills gap, just a lack of competitive wages and training options from companies. There's no doubt STEM jobs are on the rise. The Department of Commerce predicts they'll grow nearly twice as much as other professions between 2008 and 2018, and that workers in other fields are more likely to be unemployed. So how about wages? The same report shows that STEM workers earn 26% more. In fact, the top 10 paying majors for the graduating class of 2013 were all STEM. But before you reach for that Bunsen burner, let me drop some knowledge. The Bureau of Labor says the vast majority of STEM jobs are related to computers and IT. Their mean wages are higher than the U.S. average, but not by much. And guess what? Career Builder says IT jobs are the hardest ones to fill. So what about the big bucks? The five highest paying STEM graduate jobs, according to Forbes, are marine engineer, petroleum engineer, nuclear engineer, technology analyst, and chemical engineer. You know, the easy ones. So as technology evolves and becomes an even bigger part of our lives, one thing is clear. No matter what job you do, STEM will be everywhere. So make sure you're ready.
See if you can ID me. I'm a food that's been consumed for hundreds of years, first by indigenous people of Mexico. I'm made from the seeds of a fruit tree. Many would say they're best when ground up and combined with milk and sugar. I'm chocolate, and my seeds come from the cacao tree.
Those seeds are used to make everything from the chocolate we eat to the cocoa we bake with to the syrups we put on our ice cream. They were used as money by the Maya who lived in what is now Mexico. But chocolate as we know it didn't get popular until the 1850s. So, is it healthy? As part of his Living to 100 series, Dr. Sanjay Gupta looks into that. The answer? Sorta.
Everyone likes to hear that chocolate could be good for them, and the truth is that it can be, but there are a couple of caveats. First, chocolate, just because of some of the ingredients in it, tends to increase your metabolic rate a little bit. That's the number of calories you're burning just by sitting there. It is also giving you some calories, obviously, but when you take both those things in comparison, you're burning a little bit more than you're taking in, as long as you don't overdo it. So there are good chocolates and there are not so good chocolates. You've probably heard that dark chocolate's probably gonna be your best bet. In addition to that metabolic effect it has, it also is rich in more antioxidants, things that'll help clean up some of the dirty cells in your body. Cacao chocolate is not quite as popular, but it can have some health benefits as well. It can lower the bad levels of cholesterol, known as LDL, and can help raise the good levels, HDL, just a little bit. You want to find about 60 to 70% cocoa in the chocolate you might be buying. So if you want to live to 100, you can eat chocolate, but just a little bit.
Friday Night Football, watching your team blast through a banner and onto the field. Not all banners are created equal. A New York Pee Wee team found that out recently. They charged at full speed, but unfortunately for the Wallkill Mighty Mites, the sign was mightier. The first few players are clotheslined, others just pile on. To their credit, it's made out of vinyl. It was being held backwards, and the Velcro fasteners didn't break away like they should have. So even though it made the first tackle of the game, the bad sign wasn't a bad sign. The Mighty Mites won 24-0. It was truly a banner night. They'll have to decide whether to keep the sign or banner it. Either way, shouldn't be too hard to vinyl another one. I'm Carl Azus. Thank you for watching. Have a victorious weekend.